Sorry guys, it's been loud around my house, but we're finally here, man. We're finally with a video I'm doing for the culture. This is a Goon video on a character I genuinely feel like people sleep on for how disgusting he was in the early days in terms of he pulled up on everybody. Now, most people are used to the Doctor Strange that's sweet, constantly trying to help people, doing his best to pull punches, not hurt anyone. No. I'm going to talk to you guys today about classic Doctor Strange, the dude that lives to run your fade if you're disrespecting his reality. If you guys, now if you love content like this, make sure to smash the like button. Let's run it up to 500 likes for part 2, because I'm not going to lie to you guys, I was just showing Chuck all my classic Strange files. I legit have at least 5 to 10 classic Doctor Strange Goon videos I can cook up, no sweat. Right now, based on all I have, just like literally sitting on my server. So if you guys love this video, definitely show support and I'll keep making them. But anyway, this is Doctor Strange, specifically classic Doctor Strange, vibe checking gods and patrolling his mystic hood with authority. I hope you guys enjoy and let's begin. So first, you know, major deity we see Doctor Strange really shit on in Strange Tales is Nightmare. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I don't know why Nightmare kept messing with Doctor Strange. This shit was a loss from the jump. I mean, when he pulled up on Nightmare, not only did he pull up on Nightmare, he was doing so in his realm while Doctor Strange was weakened. When he pulled up on Nightmare, he literally whipped out the Path of Hoggoth and just moonwalked on his bitch ass. Like, literally, Nightmare could not stop Doctor Strange from moonwalking in his own realm. Top tier disrespect. Of course, Nightmare has to cheat. I think he was using like hostages and people to try to get Doctor Strange off that path. And Strange was like, whatever, bitch. And that's when Nightmare runs up on Strange with this spiny beast, like this demonic monster that Nightmare uses. Strange blinds Nightmare and makes him stab his own minion and then dips before literally Nightmare could respond or even react. Definitely a Goon moment for Doctor Strange on a vibe check. Next, the time that he ran up on extra dimensional soul readers. Now, this was a pretty funny story. So these beings come from a realm outside of ours, right? And they specialize in fear manipulation, soul manipulation, mind reading, all that. They're scouting Earth, right? Because, you know, they're running up on our shit. They're going to steal our shit. They encounter Doctor Strange and they read him and they go, yo, this human, whatever this dude is foreign to the concept of fear. After they say that, right? Of course, Doctor Strange, they still fuck with him. I don't know, this was a horrible play call, but they're like, yo, we're going to run up on him because if we get him out the way, we can take over Earth, no problem. This dude's clearly a menace, but if we weaken him, we're fine. They run up on him, get their asses beat. I mean, y'all know the drill. Don't run up on classic Doctor Strange. He beat the shit out of them, and then he was like, yo, y'all are trash, but where are you coming from? Because you're not from here. Finds where they're from, gets the drop on their location, jumps through dimensions to end up at theirs, right? Meets their champion. The champion's like, bro, I run this dimension. You don't want beef? And Strange is like, I literally flew dimensions for your beef, pussy. And they start battling. He folds the champion. Not only that, bullies him, completely makes him cuck down, and then seals off that dimension. That's right. Pulled up on their shit, beat the shit out of their champion, and then sealed their bitch asses off. You're not coming to Earth for free clout, bitch. Doctor Strange back then was so pressed to beat your ass because he didn't want you thinking his reality was sweet. It was hilarious. Next, his vibe check delivered to the purple dimension. For those that don't know, Agumon's the big dog in the purple dimension, right? This is obviously a realm much farther away from ours, much more powerful, and one with intense magic. Doctor Strange does not give a shit. He pulls up. Agumon's like, bro, first of all, you can't get mad at Agumon. It's his hood, right? He has every right to be like, yo, what the fuck are you doing in my hood? Says that to Strange. Strange says, look, bro, don't disrespect. They start fighting, right? They blast away at each other for hours. After that, Strange says, look, bitch, if you ever pull up on my hood again, if you ever take an earthling, if you ever do anything of that nature again, you will never get your power back or your full strength. That's right. Literally put a curse on a god of his own dimension. That is a disgusting amount of disrespect. Next, the time Doctor Strange beefed with a potentially outerversal house. Okay? This is wild. So, all these Marvel, you know, Marvel humans are crazy. They were gathered around this house, and Strange was like, bro, there's something off about this, quote, haunted house. He tries to send his astral form in. Keep in mind, his astral forms run up on Nightmare's Realm. It's going to Dormammu's Realm, all that shit. Can't get in the house. First concern. Like, why is this shit so strong? Fortunately, the Eye Agamotto, which can see through concepts, was able to pretty easily see into the house. He gets in. Confronts this being. This house turns out to be a being from a completely different space-time continuum. And this is impressive because back then in the Strange Tales cosmology, realities were all stacked. So to be from a completely different, quote, continuum would be from a completely different infinite multiverse. Like, it's absurd. He banishes the house and seals it. Like, this dude stays sealing god-type characters just for the disrespect. Next, the time, okay, so to be fair, classic Mordo's a beast, right? Like, he was considered only second really to Strange when it comes to like mortal magic users, and at the time, and the problem with Mordo was Strange would beat the shit out of him. But Mordo was even endorsed by Dormammu at one point as like his vessel. But anyways, Mordo gets jobbed out by Strange. Mordo runs up on Strange and is running up on a weaker Strange, because this is the projection of Strange. Tell me why a projection of Doctor Strange boxed the shit out of Mordo and bodied him. That's right. Can't even beat weak and Strange. F in the chat for my boy Mordo's win record against Strange in the classic era. It was dog shit. But next, we're getting back to the Nightmare disrespect. This might, every time you see Nightmare, it might get a little worse. So Strange is in Nightmare's realm, right? And Nightmare is supposed to be the big dog in his realm. It's abstract. Makes sense. That's cool. Well, Strange isn't really buying into the hype. He's like, look, bitch, you might have prepped. You might have caught me. But you won't fight me straight up for a reason. Like, Strange knew. He's like, Nightmare, you know if we really brawled, like, just straight up, I'd beat your ass. Like, there's no debate about it. You're not that strong. You're kind of, you're shit. And he ends up bodying Prep Nightmare, who had him chained up, by using hypnotism. Regular-ass hypnotism worked on Nightmare, and Doctor Strange won. Oh my god. Imagine using regular-ass, David Blaine-ass magic on the stupid parlor tricks on a god. That's crazy. Next, the time Doctor Strange casually overpowered rune magic. So I want to give you guys a little context to why shitting on god magic's crazy. This same magic blesses weapons like Mjolnir, which we've seen damage and almost kill outerversal beings. It blesses all of Odin's weapons. Odin, a dude who's literally slapboxed Infinity, and whose fights shred the Marvel multiverse. Rune magic is capable of killing Celestials. All this crazy shit. Doctor Strange was told by Loki's bitch ass that Thor was running up on Earth, right? And he wanted everyone to smoke. Strange was like, nah, I don't get run up on. Makes a spell that instantly negs the magic of Mjolnir and renders it useless. This was, like, this whole story was crazy, but the fact he was able to render the magic and the power of Mjolnir helpless? Absolutely absurd. Next, we've got a classic chain snatch moment from Doctor Strange. This one is him running up on a character named, I believe it was Zoda. Zoda had the power of the Netherworld. The Netherworld obviously being a realm beyond the regular realities and known realities. And this Nether power was amping him, right? Doctor Strange ran up on his shit, blasted Zoda. Zoda might have been a girl. Zoda, nah, I think Zoda was a guy, but he kind of looked like a bitch. I don't know. But weird facial work. But anyway, Zoda gets blasted. You know, this bald-headed bitch gets his chain snatched. And Doctor Strange was like, dope power, bro. Don't mind if I have it. And runs off. You can literally see him just fly off through the mirror and dip. Next. Oh, this was classic. So this was the build-up to the heavyweight match of the century, right? If you read Strange Tales, you're waiting for the Dormammu fight. Like, this shit was hype. The build-up was real. And Strange is talking to Ancient One. He's like, Ancient One, who's fucking with us, Big Slime? Like, who's trying to pull up on us? And Ancient One's like, look, bro, I'm not gonna hold you. Dormammu is different. Like, if we go and beef with real Dormammu, he's straight up, Ancient One goes, he's stronger than me. Like, I don't want to beef with him because he's stronger than me. Doctor Strange looks at him and says, say no, like, literally says, say no more. I'll pull up on his bitch ass myself. He heard his master, a dude he's seen help him get back from limbo and chaos itself, places that aren't even technically real. And his master's scared of Dormammu, and Strange is like, fuck it, I'll fight him, bro. He's not gonna beat me up. Like, damn that. Offers to pull up on Dormammu's realm by himself. The real, he's the chattest. Like, it's ridiculous. Next, this was another Mordo L. Remember how I said it gets worse every time we talk about Mordo? Here's a perfect case. Mordo has taken ass beatings from Doctor Strange before. That's obvious. I've shown you guys examples. Like, it is what it is, right? Well, he ran up on Doctor Strange one time, and this involved Ancient One. Doctor Strange doesn't play about the Ancient One. Don't threaten him. If you do, you're going to get your shit snatched. Well, Mordo played a dumb game, got a dumb prize. Got beaten up by Doctor Strange so bad that Mordo said, yo, Strange, I'm not going to lie. You just dragged him so bad, I really don't think we're going to see him for a very long time. And we literally didn't see Mordo for several issues. It was horrible. He got put in early retirement with an ass whooping. It was bad. Next, he makes a demon Lord Sorcerer basically have to quit his 9-to-5 to evade the L. So this, like, demon Lord Sorcerer pulls up. They're like, yo, I got infinite magic. Strange is like, look at this bitch. They start scrapping. This is not real beef to Strange. This is a walk in the fucking park at this point. He invades the mind of this sorcerer and was like, look, pussy, if you don't quit magic, if you don't give up this dumb shit you're doing, you will literally die. Like, that's it. It's a wrap. Like, you are not allowed to do what you love to do because you're such an L. And the dude had to literally retire from his hustle or else take the Strange L. It's just bad how bad he curses people. Next, the time he pulled up on Dormammu, right? I told you about the hype buildup. We finally got it. Strange was like, damn that, I'm pulling up. Pulls up to Dormammu's real realm. This is a realm between the imaginary and non-imaginary. It's beyond a set of infinity. It's beyond an infinite stack of the multiverse. All these things, right? It's considered uncountable, indescribable. Bunch of wild shit for classic Dark Dimension with Dormammu. Strange pulls up anyway. And in another video, if you want, like, more specific moments against non-god characters, I'll show it, because he fights so many characters just getting through Dormammu's realm. It's crazy. But anyways, he gets to Dormammu and he's like, yo, I heard you're lit. Like, I heard you're stupid broke. Let's fight, bitch. They start scrapping. What happened was Dormammu powers his dimension. And he would have had to sacrifice his entire crib, basically, because he would have had to use all his power to get rid of Doctor Strange. And he couldn't do that without compromising an invasion of his realm. So he had to quit against Doctor Strange because he was getting pressed too hard. And the reason for those that are like, oh, this isn't full power Dormammu, keep in mind this was a prep Dormammu who literally made Strange run, like, countless gauntlets before he even got to him. So he was trying to wear out Strange before even beefing with him for real. So I don't respect Dormammu that much. Strange really put hands on him. Final moment for this video. Obviously, you want that part two. I literally think I have at least 200 Doctor Strange moments. Smash the like button. 500 likes. I'll instantly drop part two. But anyways, the one we're going to finish with today is his beef with Taboro. Now, this was godly. Taboro of the Sixth Dimension. The Sixth just being a name. In another classic Strange comic, it's actually stated Taboro probably has infinite dimensions within just his own. But this is a realm that's beyond everything we've basically seen so far, if not equal with Dormammu's, which would make sense, but it should be outer, right? This is why this fight's hilarious. Strange pulls up on Taboro in his own dimension. And he's like, look, Taboro, I heard you're the shit here. I heard you're powerful. Like, I heard you're the big dog. And he's like, but what would happen if we threw hands? And you see Strange take his jacket off, take his cloak off, and start throwing bungalows at the ruler of an outerversal dimension. And no, you want to see part two? This is not the first time he's done that, and it's not the last. He starts beating up Taboro, just muffle miking his bitch ass, right? Just throwing hooks. Makes Taboro cheat. Taboro has to start blasting him with his own magic spells to try to stop him. Strange stops him and wins anyway. That's right. Pulled up on Taboro, beat him up with the hands, and then beat him at his best thing, which was magic. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. How big of a goon do you think classic Doctor Strange was? I obviously think he was a four because he pulled up on everything imaginable in the verse. But let me know what you guys think of him. Let me know if you want that part two. And let me know what your favorite moment from this video was. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. It's been your boy Jobbers and Goons, and I'll see y'all later. Peace.